Well, if people come into the foyer of the Reserve Bank, and they're always welcome to do that here at Martin Place, you'll see on the wall on the right-hand side, there's some letters etched into the black stone there that are from our charter. Those words are from 1945. They haven't changed since. And they're about stability of the currency, the maintenance of full employment, and the prosperity and welfare of the Australian people. Now, they're very big, broad, fine-sounding words. How do we put that into practice? Well, the way we do that is we have a medium-term target for inflation. And we talk about holding CPI inflation to 2 to 3% on average over time. In other words, preserving the value of money. That's very important because a stable money is really a foundation for economic prosperity more generally. If we don't have stable money, then whatever else we do, we won't really be able to achieve broader economic prosperity. That framework's been in place since the early 1990s. We have hit the target. Over that 20-year period, the average inflation rate's pretty close to 2.5%. So we regard that as successful by the terms of the definition that we set ourselves. And I think that's made a big contribution to economic stability more generally. And I don't think it's an accident that that period of fairly low predictable inflation has coincided with pretty good sustained growth in the economy. The target is a medium-term one, so there's a little bit of flexibility over the short term, and I think experience shows that in trying to do economic policy and trying to control inflation, there really isn't an ability to fine-tune these things over very short periods of time. You have to take a more medium-term perspective. We've always thought that, and I think experience shows that that's the right way to do it. And as I say, we've managed to achieve that target fairly well over quite a long period of time now. Sometimes things happen. Economists refer to these things as shocks, which just means they're events which are not forecastable and not controllable. Things come along. It might be a rise in global oil prices because there's military tension in the Middle East. It could be the celebrated banana price rise because the crop's been damaged by a cyclone. It could be some government policy that raises or lowers the cost of medical care. So these things come along and they affect the measured inflation rate over a short period. And we can't stop that occurring. We can't control that. But the key thing is to have inflation come back to the target over time. And the policy decision is really about trying to configure the interest rate setting so that we can be pretty sure that inflation will come back over time. And one of the key things that helps us do that is if people's expectations about inflation in the future are well anchored near the target, that actually feeds through to their behaviour, to the behaviour of wage setting, to the behaviour of businesses and the way they set prices. If they behave consistently with the target, that actually helps us achieve it. So one of the things we watch is whether those expectations are indeed well anchored or not. And that helps us to work out what response we might need when inflation starts to go off course. Well, historically, we've had this board for a very long time, since the early 1950s. It's always been a board where the governor's the chairman, but we have a majority of outside people drawn from industry, from academia, from sometimes other parts of society, who bring a common sense perspective. They bring their own commercial or academic experience, and they apply a filter of the, I suppose you could say, the educated, informed, reasonable person to the judgments that we on the inside want to bring to the decision. And for us to get the decision that we think is right, we have to convince them. And that's as it should be. That's a strong filter. I think our board, although unusual amongst other boards, there are very few, if any, other central banks that have this kind of a board. But in our country, for this kind of filter to be applied to the decision process, I think adds to the credibility, to the legitimacy that the whole process has in the eyes of ordinary people. and that's very important. So it's worked quite well for 60 years now.